Bonjour, Nishka, ça va? Je pense que tu te portes bien là où tu es et que ça fait longtemps qu'on n'a pas eu quoi ça les cours de français. Mais aujourd'hui, par la grâce de Dieu, nous voilà encore revenir. Bon, avec toi, je pense que tu es chanceuse parce que depuis l'année passée, on a déjà entamé ces livres. C'est ça les livres que tu dois utiliser entre les jeunes classes 10. Et que j'espère bien, tu connais déjà comment utiliser ces livres ici. Ok, so I was saying that I'm happy to see you again for online class and hope you are safe where you are right now. And for your French class, you need to have this textbook entre le jeune classe 10. I don't think so. I will be worried so much about you because we start this textbook since last year. Ok, how's it online class? Today, for your first class, we're going to discuss about verb. Remember, for 10th grade, you need to write more. You need to write more. You will get more marks only if you write maybe 2 or 3 pages for your board exam. Remember, for your board exam, you have letter writing, text writing, comprehension, and those are things you need to know about verb. Then you can write nicely. So, for verb in French, we have three groups of verbs. Okay, comme je le disais, let me try to explain you again in French, sorry, in English, so you can have a better understanding. So, we're going to use this textbook entre le jeune classe 10. There is no doubt for you because we started this textbook since last year, and I believe that you know how to use it, and each part of this textbook, from lesson 1 till lesson 5, I believe, we already did it in class 9. So today, I don't waste so much time of, like going back again and trying to explain all old stuff which we had in ninth grade. Ninth grade. So we're gonna start directly from a verb, because for your 10th standard French, you need to write more. You should write and write and write and write and write, 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 write. So wherever we'll be having class, you need to do homework, which I will be giving here in a board. Okay, let's start by a verb. Le verbe. Le verbe, first of all, tell me, what do you mean by verb in French? Yes, verb is action, word. Exemple, can you give me some few examples of verb? Exemple, parler. Parler, chanter, danser, dormir, revoir, many are there. So in French, we have more than 1,000 of verbs, which means there is no, we can't remember all verbs in French. So what French people did, they make all verbs, they make it in a group, in a three groups. As you can see in this board, we have three groups of verbs in French. The first group verb are verb ending with er. First of all, as we are speaking about verb, remember this: in each word or mot in French, it may be mot means what? Mot may be noun, it may be verb, it may be anything. So, mot as a verb will have two parts. Verb will have two parts. One part is radical. Radical, and one more part is terminaison. Terminaison. So radical means what? Radical is the first part of the verb which does not change. And then terminaison. Terminaison is the ending part of the verb, which means wherever we'll have any word which means a verb, that means the verb will have two big parts. The first one is radical, as you can see here. This is the radical part. This radical doesn't change. Then the ending is terminaison. E-R. Now, according to this terminaison, they made all French verbs in three groups. The first one is ER. So, ER means what? It means in the present tense of this all first verb group ER, they will have the same pattern. They will have the same ending. Present tense of mode indicatif. That means forger. So, we're going to do what? We will take out this ER, take out ER, then add E. That is forger. Fortu, take out ES, ER, and add ES. For il or elle, take out again ER, then add E. For nous, take out ER. Take out ER means what? Take this out, then add this. Take this out, then add EZ. Take this out, then add ENT. So they say that for all ER verbs, if the verb ending with ER like this, it means the conjugation will be same for remaining verb. Example, I will give one example here. As you can see, I already say parler. Parler. Parler means what, Nishka? Okay, parler means to speak. Very good. Parler means to speak. As you can see, parler, this is the radical part. It doesn't change. And this is the ending part, ER. As it belongs to the first group, that means the ending part will be like that. So, for verb, as you know, we need to have this all pronouns. J'ai, tu, il, or elle, nous, vous, il, or elle. I believe that you know already what is the meaning of this j'ai, tu, il, elle, nous, vous, il, or elle. This all in French are pronoms personnels. Pronoms personnels. That means wherever we have verb or we need to conjugate a verb, we need to have those all pronoms personnels. I can give the meaning of this also if you want. Je means I, tu means you, il or elle means it means he or she, and nous means we, vous means you again, and il means they. Okay, so the verb is ER. That means we'll have here, je parle. Let me make it first like this. Je parle. I will just write first the radical. Parle, parle for everything there. Parle, parle, parle again in for the last one. So as I said, this radical will be the same. The ending part, what is the ending part? The ending part is ER. So the rules say that we need to take out ER, then add this full part there. For je, je is the first one. That means I will have je parle, which means I speak. For tu, tu parle, add ES. That is for tu. And for il or elle, it will be again il parle, elle parle. This is for I. Nous parlons, add ONS. Vous parlez, add IZ, and last one is il or elle parle. Okay, so that means for all ER verbs, the present tense of mode indicatif will be conjugated like this way. Okay, example, now I want you to do conjugate also for danser, chanter, s'appeler. Okay, this you need to do it from your side. S'appeler. Do it. S'appeler. 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 This is the as a homework. Then, in this first group verb, they said they have one small, one exception is there. Exception means the verb ending with ER, but it doesn't belong to ER verb. What is that verb? It ends with er, but it doesn't belong to the first group. Can you give me the verb name? Okay, the verb name is aller. As you can see, aller, aller means what? Aller means to go. Aller, which means to go. Aller ends with er, but it doesn't belong to the er group. Why? Because when we start the conjugation of verb aller to the present tense of mode indicative, the ending part of aller won't be the same as the ending part of all verb. Okay, let me do it here. Example, I will have for aller, je vais. As you can see, all er verb will have the ending part will be e. According to the rule says that we need to take out er, then add e. But for aller, it will change. Je vais. Then for tu, tu vas. Il, or, elle, elle va. Nous allons. Vous allez. And the last one, it will be il, or, elle, vont. So, this aller, as the ending part is not the same for all er verb, they will put er in the categories of irregular verbs. Any doubt? Okay, I will read it again. Je vais, tu vas, il va, elle va, nous allons, vous allez, ils vont, elles vont. Any doubt for first group? No, thank you. Okay, I'm back again with the second verb group. Deuxième group, verb ending with I, har. Okay, for the first, the second group, they say the verb must ending with IS, IS, IT, ONS, EZ, and ENT. The rules will be the same. The verb will have two parts, also as well for the first group. Example, I give finir. Finir, which means to finish. Finir has two parts also. The first one is radical, and the second one is terminaison. As you can see, the terminaison of finir is IR. ER in French, IR in English. So the rule say that we need to take out, cut out this IR, then add IS, IS, IT, ONS, EZ, and ENT. So here I already did it. I have j'ai fini, as you can see, I just had IS for j, tu finis, il finit, elle finit, IT, nous finissons, vous finissez, ils finissent, elles finissent. But remember, for this second group verb, you will get some verb whose ending with will be ending with what? S, S, T, O, N, S, E, Z, then E, N, T. First of all, I want you to give me or to give me some example of ER, which will have the same conjugation like finir. Example, give me one or two. Rougir. Rougir. Rougir will be conjugated same as finir. Rougir means what? Rougir means to redden, to become red, red. J'ai rougi. Tu rougis, il rougit, elle rougit, nous rougissons, vous rougissez,
ils rougissent. Means, if I want to get the present tense of verb rougir, the conjugation will be same as this one. As you can see, sorry. Here we didn't had, okay. As I said, we'll have this way, or we may have also IS, IT. I'll write it here so you can see nicely. Let me write it here. We can have IS, IT, ISSONS, ISSEZ, then ISSENT. This is the ending part of IA verb. So here you'll get maybe 7 or 8 verbs which will ending like this. But sometime also you may get SST or ISISTONSEZ then ENT. Example I can give devenir. Devenir. As you can see, devenir, which means to become. To become. Devenir belongs to the second verb group. It ending with what? It ending with IR. So if you want to get the present tense of devenir, I will write it here. Devenir. Devenir. Je deviens. As you can see here, it's S. I didn't add I. Now it become here. Je deviens. Tu deviens. Again, S. Il or elle devient avec T. Then for nous. Tell me for nous. What will you get for nous? Okay, I will write it here. Nous devenons. ONS. And for vous, vous devenez IZ. And for il or elle, you will have elle devienne or il devienne. So that means for IR verb, you will have two ending parts. The first one is IS. Here you need to add ISSONS, ISSEZ, then ISSET. Sorry. Then the next one, you need to remove this SSTONSEZ, then ENT. So I want you to give me 5 examples of IR verb and get all the present tense of indicative mode or of mode indicative. Bye. Okay. Now the third part is, the third group is R-E-R-O-E-R. Remember, from the second group to the third group, those all group verbs, these two groups, most of the verb inside or most of the verbs belongs to these two groups are irregular verbs. So that means they don't follow exactly what the rule says there. They keep changing. Now, for the third group verb ending with R-E or O-E-R, the ending will be like this. S, nothing there for a third person of singular. O-N-S-E-Z-E-N-T. Example, I give one example here. Prendre. Prendre, which means to take. As you can see, prendre ending with R-E. That means it belongs to the third group. Now, the rule says that We need to take out this RE, then add S. Take out again. RE, add S, ONS, EZ, ENT. Now, for prendre, you will have je prends, tu prends, il prend, elle prend. As you can see, I didn't add anything there. Then, nous prenons, vous prenez, ils prennent, or elles prennent. Now, for il and elle, you need to double hand before adding ENT. Then, next example here, I give again, recevoir. Recevoir, which means to receive. Now, for recevoir, you have je reçois. It ends again with S. Tu reçois. Il reçoit. Elle reçoit. You may ask me, but why am I writing C like this? See, for us to have the sound of C in between two vowels, we need to add this CD. It's called CD. So when we learn about accent, you will see this type of accent, CD. Okay? It helps us to get the sound of C or C sound. Otherwise, this C will be pronounced as qui. Then, je reçois, ending with S, tu reçois, il reçoit, elle reçoit. I believe you can't see for nous. I will write it here again. Nous recevons. For nous recevons, there is no this one here because it's A is there. Nous recevons. Vous recevez. And then the last one will be ils reçoivent. Ils reçoivent or elles reçoivent. So, this is the few things of French verb. So, as like this, today for the first class, we just had present tense of all three verbs. So, from your side, I want you to give me 150 verbs. 150 verbs. I didn't say conjugation. 50 verbs in French and get all meaning in English. 150. Just writing for ER, for example, chanter. Chanter means to sing. It belongs to the first group. First group. Like that, 150. So do it and send it from school board, school panel. Thank you.